अष्टोत्तर सदस्यमा भक्त विद्वान सरस्वती गोस्वामी को अनंत कोटि वैष्णविंद के नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तविंद के श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गो गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय वृंदावन धाम की जय नवदीप धाम की जय गंगाबाई की जय यमुनाबाई की जय तुलसी देवी की जय भक्ति देवी की जय स्वामी तो भक्तविंद की जय ऑल ग्लोरी टू जस्ट ऑल ग्लोरी टू जस्ट थैंक यू वेरी मच
ऑल ग्लोरी टू श्री
प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रवृत्तानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवाचार्य गौर ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
This is a conversation between Maharaj Parikshit and Sukhdev Goswami. Maharaj Parikshit, 5,000 years ago, he was the emperor of the whole world. Formerly, up to 5,000 years ago, the whole world was being controlled and ruled over by kings whose capital was Hastinapur, New Delhi. There was only one flag, only one ruler, one scripture, Vedic scripture, and the Aryans, Arya, they were the civilized persons. You, Europeans, Americans, you are also Aryans, Indo-European stock, Maharaj Jajasi, grandson of Maharaj Parikshit. He gave to his two sons the portion of Eastern Europe, Greek and Roman. That is the history. Mahabharata. Mahabharata means Great India. So there was no different religion. One religion, Vedic religion. Vedic religion means to accept the Supreme Personality of Godhead as the Supreme Person, Absolute Truth. This is Vedic religion. Those who have read Bhagavad Gita, it is said there in the 15th chapter, Vedaishta sarvai ahamiva vedyam. Vedic knowledge means to understand God. This is Vedic. Later on, with the progress of Kali Yuga, Kali Yuga means the dark age or the sinful age or the age for argument, unnecessary talks and fight. This is called Kali Yuga. That is going on. Since the last 5,000 years, the Kali Yuga has begun, and the beginning of Kali Yuga was cow slaughtery. So, at the present moment, practically there is no Brahmin, no Kshatriya, no Vaishya, only Shudras, fourth class men. So you cannot expect any happiness guided by the fourth class men. That is not possible. Therefore, throughout the whole world, there is chaotic condition. Nobody is happy. So this is essential, that the human society must be divided into four divisions. The Brahmin class means the first class, ideal man, so that by the seeing their character, their behavior, others will try to follow. Jadjadacharati Sreshtha. So this Krishna consciousness movement means We are trying to create some first class man. This is Krishna consciousness. This moment. So, therefore, we have got these rules and regulations. No illicit sex, no meat eating, no intoxication, no gambling. This is the preliminary qualification of a first class man. So, we are trying our bit to make some men, ideal first class men. But formally, it was there. Chatur is still there. You don't think that all men are of the same intelligence or same category. No. Still there is intelligent class of men, just like those who are scientists, those who are philosophers, religionists. They are supposed to be first class men. But unfortunately, now nobody can recognize who is first class and last class. Proper management of the whole society, the first class, second class, third class, men must be there. Just like in your body, there are different parts of the body, the head, the arm, the belly, and the leg. This is natural. So without head, if we have simply the arms and belly and legs, it is a dead body. So unless you are guided, the human society, by the first class man, the whole society is dead society. There must be division. According to Chatur Bannang, Maya Srishtam Guna Karma, not by birth, but by quality. So anyone can be trained up first class, second class, as he likes. That is called civilization. In mother's womb, there is a small body. It grows, and we come out. Again it grows. Growth, it is not actually growing, it is changing. The child is changing his body to baby, the baby is changing his body to boy, and the boy is changing his body to youthhood. Then, in this way you are changing body, that you have got experience. You had a child's body, you remember. Or you had a boy's body, you remember. But the body is no longer existing. But you are existing. Therefore, the conclusion is that when this body will be no more fit for existing, we shall have to accept another body. This is called tatha dehantara prapti. So we have to change. That is nature's law. The soul is immortal. Na jayate na mriyate va kadachit na hannate hannamane sarire. The soul is not finished. Simply a particular type of body being finished. No. The people do not know it. And because they are simply engaged in sinful activities, their brain has become so dull that they cannot understand the simple truth. That as you are changing body in this life, therefore you change this body to another life. This is very simple truth. But at the advancement of material civilization, we have become so dull and rascal that we cannot understand. Common senses. That is the way. Sarvapadhi vinimuktam tatparatena nirmalam. Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam Bhakti Rucha. This bhakti means that we have to clear ourselves from the designation. What is that designation? Everyone is thinking, I am American, I am Indian, I am European, I am Australian, I am cat, I am dog, I am this, I am that, body. We have to cleanse this bodily conception of life, that I am not this body. Aham Brahmasmi, I am spirit soul. This you have to realize. Then there will be no distinction that here is an American, here is an Australian, here is a Hindu, here is a Muslim, here is a tree, here. No. Pandita Samadarshina. Pandita means learned, one who knows things as they are. For them, Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmane Gavi Hastini Sunice Cha Sapake Cha Pandita Samadarshina. A person very learned, Vidya, and very gentle. Vidya means, educated means he is gentle, sober. He is not rogues and ruffian. That is Vidya. That is the taste of education. He must be very educated, sober and silent. That is called gentleman. In one word. Abhuta prasannātmā na sochati na kāṅkati samasarveshu bhūtesu madhbhakti ravati parā. When one is self-realized that he is not this body, he is the spirit soul, Paramabhuta. So these two things will be finished if you become spiritually situated. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Nasuchati Nakankati Samas Sarvesu Bhuteshu. Unless one is spiritually realized, he cannot see equally everyone. Then Samas Sarvesu Madhavakti Lavati Para. Then one can become real devotee of the Lord. After surpassing the Brahma-bhuta stage. So this bhakti line is not so easy. But by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, we have installed the deity here in your country. We are very fortunate that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to your country to teach you how you become free of all anxieties. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. Everyone is full of anxiety, but everyone can be free from all the anxieties if he follows the path chalked out by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. As people are whole in this age, the method also has been offered very simply. They have been recommended simply to chant the holy name of God. That's all. And what is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instruction? Very simple. Harir nama, harir nama, harir nama iva kevalam, kalau nasti iva, nasti iva, nasti iva, gatinam. This is not Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's personal version. This is in the scripture, Vedic scripture, beyond Naradiya Purana. This instruction is there. They cannot follow any strong or severe austerity. It is not possible. Anyone can do. It is not difficult at all. Then if you say that you are from India, your Chaitanya is Indian, and he is commanding Hare Krishna, why shall I chant? I have got my own God. All right. If you have got your own God, then you chant His name. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doesn't say that you chant simply Krishna's name. If you have got any relationship with God, and if you know His name and address, then you chant His name. Unfortunately, you do not know who is God, neither you know his address, neither his activities. So take this Krishna. Here is a solid name, and he give you his address, his father's name, his mother's name, everything. So, if you have got your own God's name, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can chant. Have you got any name? The Krishna, his name, his form, his activities, his qualities, we cannot understand with this blunt material senses. It is not possible. Atasya Krishna Namadi na bhavet grahyam indriya. Then we have got this only possession, indriyas, how we shall understand. Sevanmukhi jivadu. If you engage your senses in the service of the Lord, Sāme vas purattas, then Krishna will reveal to you the error. This is the first. Now, this word is very significant. Sevanmukhi jivadu. Jivā means tongue. If you simply engage your tongue in the service of the Lord, in gradually. Then how to engage the tongue? It is not said that if you see or if you touch, if you smell, no, if you taste. So what is the business of the tongue? The business of the tongue that we can taste nice food stuff and we can vibrate. Do these two jobs. Vibrate with your tongue Hare Krishna and take as much as possible prasad. And you become a devotee. Thank you very much.
Test
it. Make a trial. The temple is here. We are inviting. Come here. Do these two business. And our Madhubhisa Maharaj is ready to give you prasada and chance for dancing and singing. Where is the difficulty?
It means we talk together. Whole universe, does that mean all the worlds in the universe, or just this earth?
You're just wondering how it was possible for one king to rule a whole world. Seems like it is very difficult. Nowadays we have so many leaders and they cannot manage.
Don't forget that. Where you're thinking that you cannot rule a world, therefore others cannot. You are thinking in your turn. But there are, that is possible. But that is not our field of activities. It is others, politics and... But let us, our business is how to improve our spiritual condition of life. Even if you don't rule over the world, it doesn't matter. So why you are anxious to rule over the world? It is not our business. You chant Hare Krishna and take prasad.
भक्ति वेदन कर सहमा